Hi, my name is Svan with the 3D scanning company Holocreators, and today I want to show you how to make a reverse engineering of a mechanical part with free software. So we took this part here and 3D scanned it, and in this tutorial I will show you how to take the 3D scan of this part and turn it into a CAD file, so STL file to step file conversion. And there you can see how the 3D scan is turning. That is the polygon mesh. And afterwards, you can see the CAD file. So that is the reconstructed part. How does it work? Well, I will show you the 7 steps which are needed to make this reverse engineering. You will need 2 free software packages. You will need Netfabb. That's for taking measurements on the STL file, on the 3D scan. And you will need FreeCAD. That's for reconstructing the part in CAD. This is a rather basic tutorial now. If you want to know how to do it in detail, click by click, we also have a 2-hour tutorial prepared where you can really follow from the beginning to end how to reconstruct this part here. So this is more of a basic overview. Step number 1 is taking measurements in Netfabb and creating a reference sketch in FreeCAD. Here you can see the UI of Netfabb. First we make a new measuring. And then we click on the measure radius. Please pay attention to also activate the button 3 points on circle. And then on the outside of this flange, we select 3 points. And Netfabb will automatically create the measurement and tell us, well, it's 75.97 millimeters. So let's make it an even 76 millimeters. Then we go back to FreeCAD and create a reference circle and define the circle radius, which is 76 divided by 2. And now we have our reference circle. Step 2 is making a correct placement of the 3D scan inside FreeCAD, because right now the scan is not properly oriented. So it's like this inside the 3D realm, and we will adjust the part so it's perpendicular to the axis. We go into FreeCAD and click on placement down in the menu, and then on the 3 dots. Then we click on apply incremental changes to object placement. Then we change into a side view and we oriented the part until it's perpendicular to the x-axis. Then we change the view and change the 3D scan so it's also perpendicular to the y-axis. And then we change to the top view and make sure that it's within the center of the circle. Step 3 is change the transparency of the 3D scan inside FreeCAD and create a profile. This is so we can construct on the side view of the 3D scan. In FreeCAD, we press Ctrl D to enter the transparency menu and set the transparency to about 60%. Then we create a new sketch and choose the XY axis as the layer. And then we start sketching on the cross-section of the flange. And we have to define the constraints, and that is by adding the measurements. So we remember the radius was 76 divided by 2, so 38 millimeters, and we type that in. And now it's constrained. And now we have to switch a lot of back and forth between Netfabb and FreeCAD until the sketch is fully constrained, and then it will be green. And then we can use it to rotate the profile and create our flange. Step 4 is hiding parts of the polygon mesh to construct on top of the cross section. In FreeCAD, you click on the scissors symbol and then you have this blue line with which you can choose the area that you want to hide. You do a right click and click on inner. And then you have this cut view, and then you can create a new sketch, a new plane, and then go into the menu and adjust the Z value until the new layer is at the same height as the cut, and then switch into a top view and create a new sketch. And then it's like last time, creating a sketch and making it fully constrained, so it's finished. In step 5, we are connecting all the profile sketches with the loft command to create a new part. In FreeCAD, you can see all the different profile sketches that we made. For simplicity reasons, we are only going to use the outside ones. And then we click on the loft command and select the profiles one by one, and then we have our part. In step 6, we connect all the parts with the Boolean operation and finally export the file as a step file. In FreeCAD, now you can see all the different parts which need to be combined. All these parts have been made with the different modeling techniques, and we select them one by one until they are all green and hit this button with the two circles, the Boolean operation. And then we can go to export and save the file as a step format. And then the part is complete. Step 7. This is a kind of quality control. So we have created our new CAD file, and now we want to compare it with the 3D scan. We want to see how precise we worked and how much difference there is between the original 3D scan and the new CAD file. For this, we use a software called GOM Inspect. You can also download this software for free. I will put the link in our blog. And this will allow us to overlay both parts and see how much deviation is between them. This is the UI of GOM Inspect. Here you can see the overlay process, where we overlay the 3D scan with the step model that we created. And then we can see the different colors show us how much the deviation is between both parts. So these were the basic 7 steps how to make a reverse engineering using free software. If this went too fast, you can always go back and look at the individual steps. If you want to know it in more detail, we have prepared a 2-hour tutorial, which I will also link inside the blog and inside the description of this video. If all of this is too much hassle for you, we are happy to help. As I said, we are a reverse engineering company and 3D scanning company, so we always like to help you with your projects. Otherwise, have a great day and see you next time. Bye-bye.